Great. So hi, everyone. I'm Karen Drudsky, and I'm a senior solution architect at NRI. I do a lot of speaking on the East Coast at the community events here that are held. And let's see, let me get into my presentation like I need to. When I saw the ad for the SharePoint Hackathon, I got really excited. I do mostly no-code or low-code solutions in SharePoint, even though I've been working in it since 2003. And so I contacted some of my other low-code, no-code SharePoint folks on our team and said, hey, let's do something. And they agreed. And so here you can see our entire team of folks who work together to come up with this, because we're all really busy doing consulting and we don't have a lot of time. So we all pitched in and put together to come up with the idea and everything. And I am joined here by Bailey. I'm going to let Bailey introduce herself and the rest of the team.
So my name is Bailey Hansen. I'm a business analyst, also with NRI. It's a joy to work with Karen and everybody on the project. Our other two members who weren't able to come today are Libby Fissett, our Director of Innovation, and Cassandra Brill, Senior Business Architect. So we put together our ideas, and we had a resource that was very that existed already that was pretty beneficial, which was a demo portal. So again, as consultants, we like to be able to show the art of the possible to folks. So we have an existing space where we throw nice stuff out so that we can demo it and also to do testing and pieces. So with benefits, one of the pieces, Karen did all the technical work with the agent, did a great job. I dug in to make sure that our data was accurate, because as we know, garbage in, garbage out. And my personal pet peeve, if you never post about your gym benefits on your website, on your intranet, no one will ever be able to find it. So did a little bit of work making sure we actually had 2025 documents out on that benefit space. But I think the agent, especially like for our clients or for whoever, wow, talk about a way to surface that and get to the answer that, you know, you dig around for 20 minutes to find something, the agent can find it so much faster. So Karen, I'll let you take her away.
Okay, so I didn't want to have to worry about the demo guide, so I set this all up as a video. And you can see that if you have a Copilot license on this site, you're able to go in and use the agent, and we have the benefits agent there. And you can ask questions and everything, and Michael did a great job of showing how you create an agent. So we're just going to take and go in here and edit our agent and show you what we did. So we gave it its name. We didn't change the logo, which was default from the site. We put in a description for it. And our source was, as Bailey said, it was the benefits site, the entire site. So it was really easy. We could have done like Michael did and gone into libraries and folders, but we didn't. And we were a little bit simpler with what we had. We had our welcome message. We created some starter prompts and then gave our agent some basic instructions on what we wanted it to do. So then we went over and tried it out and put in the first one that we had, which was to find a holiday schedule. And it did. We waited to see what it would give us back and looked, and sure enough, it brought back an accurate holiday schedule from our site. We actually did a few more tests on it to make sure that it was bringing back the information we expected it to bring back, and it did. And we did see the copy link for Teams, so we said, hey, this would be really cool if we could use it in Microsoft Teams. So we copied the link. And after doing that, went and tested that out with Bob the Builder and Milton. And so Bob added it to a conversation that he, or a chat he was having with Milton. And you can see that the benefits agent was added to Teams. And then it actually introduced itself in the chat. And Milton saw it and said, hey, you know, what's the holiday schedule? And nothing happened. And so Bob's like, oh, we have to mention the agent. And when that was done, then it came back right away. Well, Milton said, well, let me try that again, and did it, but asked when is open enrollment, and got, you know, something went wrong. So you're like, that's interesting. So then Bob tried it again and it worked. So we realized that if you don't have a Copilot agent, or if you don't have a Copilot license, that you're not going to be able to use the agent, even if it's in a Teams chat or conversation in a team. But we thought that was really cool, though, that someone who does have a license could, because not everyone in our organization has a Copilot license. And most of the organizations we work with, there are very few of them where they roll it out to everyone all at one time. It's usually a small group, and then it gets expanded based on need. So it was pretty simple, very straightforward. And I'll let Bailey talk about what we learned from this.
So what we learned, definitely, that this is very user-friendly to create. Again, we were a little short on time, so we had to pull together what we could and what sounded interesting on the speed we had. I do think it's also interesting that while only the Copilot license holder can use that, it can be included for folks who don't have licensing. So one person with that license can facilitate some of those questions and conversations, which is a lot better than not having that capability at all. That's very cool. And it is, like I said, it is possible to have the license users assist unlicensed in that Teams chat and in that space. So again, always great to see a tool that can be leveraged for folks who don't have direct access and can streamline that. So this is a lot of fun, definitely going to play around with it. And we're excited to keep using it and keep building on it.